place where we were. The building is somewhat deteriorated since we've been here, but nonetheless, we thank God for the time that we spent here nonetheless. We're going to go right into our broadcast. As always, if you're visiting here, we thank God for you. If you're not, thank God for you also. It's broadcast time. As soon as we get the signal from Brother Whitted, we're going to get started. In the name of Jesus Christ. This, ladies and gentlemen, is again the Worldwide Truth of God radio and television program coming to you from the First Church of our Lord Jesus Christ of the Apostles' Faith. Our location is 2431 Frankfort Avenue, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, here in the United States of America, where Pastor Gino Jennings, our leader, teacher, guide, and general overseer. Saludos a todos nuestros. Radio escuchas de habla hispana en el nombre de Jesucristo. Este es el programa radial Verdad de Dios con el Pastor Gino Jennings. Nos salutación a tous nos auditeurs francophones au nom de Jésus-Christ. Nous sommes La Vérité du Dieu, programme radiophonique avec le pasteur Gino Jennings. Baptist Minister Stephen Williams will now lead us in prayer.
Father God, we do come to you once again in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. My God, we thank you, Lord God, again for this opportunity. How you allowed us, dear God, to be able to come and worship you, Father God, in spirit and in truth. We thank you, Lord God, once again for how you've blessed, dear God, the church. My God, we thank you, Lord God, for this 14th church and pastoral anniversary. Lord God, we thank you, Lord, how you blessed the man of God. My God, and allowed him, dear God, to operate in truth. My God, for 14 years. Father God, we thank you, Lord God, for the progress, my God, of the church. Father God, we thank you, Lord God, how you have allowed us to increase and not decrease, my God, in 1 year. My God, in the name of the Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, how you've been merciful. Lord God, how you've been kind, my God, unto the man of God. My God, we thank you, Lord God, for the wisdom, Lord God, knowledge and understanding that you have given him. My God, to be able to preach and teach, my God, the words of truth. My God, not only to the saint, but to the sinner also. My God, to give us a chance, O God. My God, that we may inherit eternal salvation. My God, we thank you, Lord God, how you was able to bring us out of gross darkness. My God, and allowed us to come into your marvelous light. My God, bless, dear God, those that hear, my God, the truth of the gospel. Help them, O God. Open up their understanding to thine word. My God, bless those that are in prison. My God, continue, dear God, to reach them. My God, that are behind bars. My God, that you may bless them also. Lord God, to repent. Lord God, and be born of water and of spirit. My God, in the name of the Lord Jesus. My God, look on the drug dealer. My God, bless them also. Lord God, that they may come out of that lifestyle. Lord God, and come over. Lord God, into the knowledge of truth. My God, bless the children. Look down upon them. My God, remember them, O God. My God, many that are committing crimes, O God. My God, but help them, O God. Bring them out of darkness. My God, into your marvelous light. My God, continue to help us. My God, continue to bless us. Continue, dear God, to encourage our hearts. My God, our minds and our souls. My God, in the truth of the gospel. My God, now we do pray and ask all these things in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
just joined us, you're listening to the Worldwide Truth of God radio and television program, coming to you from the First Church of our Lord Jesus Christ of the Apostles' Faith. Our address is 2431 Frankfort Avenue, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, here in the United States of America, where Pastor Gino Jennings is our leader, teacher, guide, and general overseer. Now, you can write or email us for any of the following: a current listener of all our radio and television stations, a listener of our church locations both within and outside the United States, a listener of biblical literature written by Pastor Jennings and the church's magazine, The Truth of God Journal, the second edition, which is now available for $5. A cassette recording of this, The Truth of God radio and television program, can also be obtained at the cost of $5. However, in writing and requesting copies of this broadcast, we'd always ask that you indicate the program number clearly, very clearly, within your correspondence. Now, today's or tonight's program number is 436. Once again, a cassette recording of this, The Truth of God radio and television program, can be obtained at the cost of $5. However, when writing and requesting copies of this broadcast, please indicate the program number clearly within your correspondence. Today's or tonight's program number is 436. Again, that number is 436. Now, if you desire to have the gospel preached in your area, in person, by Pastor Jennings, or have questions regarding this program, or simply regarding the Bible, again, you may address all your correspondence to Pastor Gino Jennings, First Church of our Lord Jesus Christ of the Apostles' Faith. Our address is 2431 Frankfort Avenue, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 19125. For those who wish to, you can also email us, our email address being dthom4422@aol.com. That email address again is dthom4422@aol.com. I have a special note to our shortwave listeners in the United Kingdom. Pastor Jennings will be preaching in Brixton, London, England. That's Brixton, London, England, at the Brixton Town Hall. Those dates are Wednesday, July the 15th, and Thursday, July the 16th, 1998. Now, worship services will be at 7 p.m. each night, and of course, all our listeners throughout the United Kingdom are cordially invited to be with us on those days of services. Once again, to our shortwave listeners in the United Kingdom, Pastor Jennings will be preaching in London, England, in Brixton. That's Brixton, and specifically at the Brixton Town Hall. Now, those dates are Wednesday, July the 15th, and Thursday, July the 16th, 1998. Worship services will be at 7 p.m. each night, and of course, all our shortwave listeners throughout the United Kingdom are cordially invited to be with us. And quickly to our Spanish-speaking listeners, saludos a todos nuestros. Radio escuchas de habla hispana en el nombre de Jesucristo. Este es el programa radial Verdad de Dios con el Pastor Gino Jennings. Esta transmisión llega a ustedes de la primera iglesia de nuestro de Señor Jesucristo de la Fe de los Apóstoles, localizada en el 2431 de la Avenida Frankfort, en Filadelfia, Pensilvania, 19125, en los Estados Unidos de América. El plan verdadero de Dios para nuestra salvación requiere que usted se arrepienta y sea bautizado en el agua en el nombre de Jesucristo para el perdón de sus pecados y que usted reciba el don del Espíritu Santo, según lo dice la Biblia. Le invitamos a que nos escriba y solicite los siguientes folletos bíblicos gratis titulados ¿Ha nacido usted de nuevo? Mujeres predicadoras, y Jesucristo es Dios Todopoderoso. Una vez más, nuestra dirección es Primera Iglesia de Nuestro Señor Jesucristo de la Fe de los Apóstoles, 2431 Avenida Frankfort, Filadelfia, Pensilvania, 19125, al cuidado de Pastor Gino Jennings en los Estados Unidos de América. Que Dios les bendiga. Esperamos que nos escriban pronto. That's to our Spanish-speaking listeners. Now I'm honored to present unto you the servant of God and general overseer, our leader, teacher, and guide, Pastor Gino Jennings.
Greetings, brothers and sisters and friends, and to my listening enemies. This is First Church of our Lord Jesus Christ of the Apostles' Faith. We are located at 2431 Frankfort Avenue, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, in the United States of America, where you're always welcome to come and hear the Word of God preached according to God's eternal Word. Amen. We're forever grateful, moreover, for His loving kindness and His much mercy, that he show on us in these last and evil days wherein we live. Radio listeners, in the midst of this church anniversary, we decide to go back and trace many of the things that God have done for us. The broadcast you heard last week, it was from the basement from where we started on Jerome Street. And from Jerome Street, we rented a recreation section of an Episcopalian church. And we was there for a couple of years, and this is where the broadcast is originating today.
Amen.
We came from Jerome Street to Briar Road. And we're back today on Briar Road, just remembering what God have done for us.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
It is not in as good shape as it was when we was here. But when I look at this place, I'm glad I don't have to run around looking for a headquarters temple no more.
Amen.
We did a lot of moving around, a lot of searching. I've seen so many churches. Some look so beautiful, they didn't need no work. You could have just went in there and start right away saying hallelujah. God ain't wanted that way. So the Lord bless us with Frankfort Avenue that looked like a surviving series from World War II one time. Looked like a battle zone, didn't it? We walked in there and the brothers looked, some shook their head. And scripture says, and they hissed at him. And they hissed at me. Scripture said how they wagged their head. And it was a mess. One part of the church, it was a puddle of water so big, it looked like little fish was in it. Little mosquitoes and insects and other vain predators. But you come in there and look now, you wouldn't know it was in such bad condition.
Amen.
It is a beautiful temple that's dedicated unto the Lord. So we're glad to be here back on Briar Road just for a few more minutes or a little bit longer. But this is where our worldwide broadcast began.
Amen.
Lord. Right here from this pulpit.
Amen.
Not exactly from this podium, but when we first came here, we brought our homemade podium with us.
Yes,
it was a dresser, had clothes in it. I don't know who helped move the dresser here, but they even left the clothes in it. Once in a while, I would pull the dresser out and look at the clothes in it. But it is good to remember where God brought you.
Amen.
Had a good time in the basement meeting.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible said where the Lord is, there's liberty.
Amen.
Amen. I don't need a crowd to get happy.
Amen.
I get happy with God and I.
Amen.
Amen. But it's good to see folk that you can share the joy with, you know.
Amen.
All right, listeners, I'm tired as you can tell, but I got enough spunk to slap you over with the Bible.
That's right.
Amen. One thing is a tired fight when you fight the devil.
Amen.
It's tiring. I get tired of fighting the devil.
Mm-hmm.
That fool don't have sense enough to get tired. Amen. When you tired, he just getting started. Amen. He just keep fighting and keep fighting and keep fighting and... You know, there's a song that sang about the Lord that he never sleep and he never slumber.
Mm-hmm.
I'm starting to wonder about the devil, too.
Amen.
Because that hell-bound thing just stay up all the time.
Amen.
All the time just up, bothering your mind, up in your head, trying to defuse things.
Amen.
Trying to unravel your mind to get you out there with his children.
Amen.
You know, if he can get you out there with his children, then bless God, he got you lost with him.
That's right.
Let us remember that the devil cannot be saved on any terms.
Oh, no.
Not by any means.
Oh, no.
Can the devil be saved? Until the Bible says his place was not found anymore.
Amen.
So he's out of heaven for good.
Amen.
And thank God for that.
Amen.
All right, let's go to work in the Bible. And the book of Acts of the Apostles.
Amen.
Want to call your attention to what we preached on our first broadcast we made here, listeners. Give me Acts chapter 2, begin at verse 36.
Amen. Acts 2 and at verse 36.
It's for you because billions of you still haven't done this.
No.
Amen.
You haven't done it. You've done something, but this wasn't it.
Amen.
All right, let's have it.
Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly.
That what?
That God hath made that same Jesus, whom ye have crucified, both Lord and Christ.
Now, ready, old listeners, and let us understand something. When the Bible says God hath made that same Jesus,
whom ye have crucified,
that means the man Christ Jesus was made or created or formed or fashioned by the Spirit.
Amen. That's right.
Amen.
Now when we preach Jesus Christ as God, we're not talking about the man.
Amen. No, no.
For the man was not God.
Amen. That's right.
That's right.
The man was not God.
Amen.
What was in the man was God.
That's right.
So and say, well, how can you say Jesus Christ is God? The man was Jesus, yes. But the Spirit name was Jesus before the man was even born.
That's right.
You better give me the book of Luke if I'm correct, chapter 2.
Chapter 2, amen.
Let's see how long was the name here. The name was here long before the Son of God got here.
That's right.
Listen at the Bible, listeners. I want to educate you, teach you, and instruct you. Then perhaps you won't go to hell in your false church.
That's right. Amen.
I just want to kind of snag you, you know, because you're leaning over there.
Amen.
You're on your way, but if I can pull your shirt out and just pull you back to the Bible, perhaps I can brace you.
That's right.
All right.
Luke chapter 2 and at verse 21.
I want to take my time and soak you. Let's have it.
And when 8 days were accomplished for the circumcising of the child.
Yes.
His name was called Jesus.
His name was called Jesus.
Which was so named of the angels.
Which was so named of the angels.
Before.
When.
Before.
When.
Before.
Before what?
He was conceived in the womb.
Name was already here.
Already here.
Before he ever got to the womb.
That's right.
The name was here, and the Son of God simply inherited or took on. The name of the Spirit.
That's right.
In order for him to represent God, he had to publish God's name.
Amen. Amen.
So he had to take on the same name that God had, that is Jesus.
Jesus.
And Hebrew is Yeshua.
That's right.
Jesus is a Greek and English name.
Mm-hmm.
So, listeners, the Bible said that all.
Let all the house of Israel.
Everybody that is of Israel's house. Everybody.
Everybody.
That goes for you too, Jew. I know you got your little round skull cap on, but
that's right.
The Messiah came already.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Already came.
The Messiah already came.
Amen.
And it was not Elijah Muhammad.
No, it wasn't.
No, that's not the Messiah.
That's right.
Amen. The Messiah was not Master Farad Muhammad.
No.
The Messiah was not Buddha.
No, it wasn't.
Amen.
The Messiah was not Moses.
That's right.
There was only one Messiah. One.
Mm-hmm.
Listen at the Bible.
St. John chapter 4 and at verse 25.
Yeah.
The woman saith unto him.
The woman said to him.
I know that Messiah cometh.
I know the Messiah is coming.
Which is called Christ.
Which is called. Oh, just a minute.
Amen.
I know the Messiah is coming.
Which is called Christ.
Which is called Muhammad.
Which is called Christ.
Well, there's we got kind of a name mix up here.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Oh, we got some trouble here because there's a lot of little rascals and Spanky and Buckwheat and whatnot.
That's right.
Running around saying they're Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. But the Bible says what?
I know that Messiah is coming.
I know the Messiah is coming.
Which is called Christ.
Which is called Christ.
When he is come.
When he is come.
He will tell us all things.
Tell us everything.
Jesus saith unto her.
What?
I that speak unto thee.
I that's talking to you.
Am he.
All right, everyone else might as well shut up.
That's right.
Amen.
Huh? I can say it so relaxing and confident. Amen. You might as well just shut up.
That's right.
Glory to God. Shut up.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Do you hear what the Bible said?
I know that Messiah is coming.
Do you hear that, listeners?
Amen.
Now, I know many of you, your preachers, got themselves, made themselves a Messiah.
That's right.
I remember I heard the national representative of the Nation of Islam in the medicine field, the national minister of health, he got up and thanked Allah for the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Then he got up and thanked Allah for Minister Louis Farrakhan. Then he said, I thank Allah for not sending us one Messiah,
my Lord,
but two Messiahs.
My Lord.
You've been duped, bub.
Amen.
Ain't no two Messiahs over here.
No, it's not.
Huh?
No, no.
Because according to the Bible, Jesus said,
I know that Messiah is coming.
Now, do you understand what is the Messiah, not what is a Messiah?
That's right.
No.
That's right.
When you say a Messiah and the Messiah, it's two different things.
That's right.
That's right.
The Messiah is more than a prophet.
Amen. Amen.
The Messiah is more than a man.
Amen.
The Messiah is not a common man.
That's right.
Amen.
The Messiah is extraordinary.
That's right. Amen.
The Messiah is above all other prophets.
All other prophets.
In fact, the Messiah qualified prophets to be prophets.
That's right.
Amen. Do you understand?
That's right.
But when a man come along and say he is a Messiah. Yeah. He's just someone that have some kind of message in his mouth.
That's right.
You know, just some ideas. And,
that's right.
And got together in his head and they sound pretty well. And he decided to give them out to some people who's willing to listen.
Amen.
But it's not wrapped around with Bible.
No, no.
Listen to what the word says here.
The woman saith unto him, I know that Messiah cometh.
Yes.
Which is called Christ.
Uh-huh.
When he is come.
When he is come.
He will tell us all things.
He will tell us everything.
Jesus saith unto her.
What?
I that speak unto thee am he.
Now.
Amen.
Jesus said he's the one.
That's right.
That you're looking for.
That's right. Amen.
The Jesus that is talking here, he is not making reference to a ship coming out of space.
No, no. No, he's not.
No, sir.
Are you listening to me?
That's right.
He is not making reference to a ship named Jesus.
No, no.
Coming from space to rescue some people out of the earth.
Amen.
You know, in history, they say it was a ship named Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
In the time of the slave trade.
Amen.
And the slaves who supposed to been waiting to be rescued from the former slave master was waiting on a ship called Jesus.
That's Amen.
And this is where the religion have came from and somehow it got sucked into Islam.
That's right.
Not into Orthodox Islam, but into the Nation of Islam. And the Jesus whom we are waiting to arrive to the earth to take away his church.
Amen.
Islam say it is not the Jesus whom many philosophers and historians say walked the earth 2,000 years ago. But the Jesus that people is waiting on is a ship that's called the mothership.
That's right. That's
the mothership named Jesus.
Amen.
Somehow we're going to sail from the sky.
In the skies. My Lord.
That's so far out of hell, it makes me more tired.
Amen. Amen.
It ain't no ship named Jesus coming from the sky.
No, it's not.
Amen.
Not at all.
Not at all.
The one that's coming, every eye shall see him.
That's right.
A ship is not a him, a ship is a it.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
Are you listening?
That's right.
First chapter, book of Revelation, let's break it down.
Amen.
First chapter, book of Revelation, begin at verse 1. Let's
Revelation
break it down.
1 and verse 1.
All right, follow me, listeners. Get your pencils ready.
That's right.
Because we want to take you to school today.
Amen.
All right.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The revealing of Jesus Christ.
Which
the knowledge of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The understanding of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
The revelation of Jesus Christ means the revealing of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
That means Jesus was revealed. Mm. Knowledge, understanding, wisdom about God was imparted to John, brother of James, sons of Zebedee.
That's right.
Amen. All right.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The revealing of God.
Which God gave unto him.
Which God gave to John.
To show unto his servants.
To show unto his servants.
Things which must shortly come
to pass. Things that must shortly come to pass.
And as he sent and signified it by his angel.
Yeah.
Unto his servant John.
Uh-huh.
Who bear record of the word of God.
Now, brothers and sisters. PhD, doctors of divinity.
Amen.
Professors of ignorance.
That's right.
Do you hear the Bible talking?
Who bear record
the apostles bear record of God's word.
God's word.
Meaning this.
Amen.
The word of the Lord came and spoke to them.
That's right.
Amen. That's right.
Then they wrote the words of God.
That's right.
Do you understand?
That's right.
The Bible talk about with pen.
And ink.
Amen. I want to certify as I go because the philosophers and the Bible scholars are so ignorant. You sat in school so long until you just didn't get it in school.
That's right.
The depth says not in me.
Right.
Listen at the Bible.
Amen.
Let's have it.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
Which God gave unto him.
Which God gave unto him.
To show unto his servants.
Show unto his servants.
Things which must shortly come to pass.
Things that must shortly come to pass.
And he sent and signified.
What?
By his angel unto his servant John.
And?
Who bear record of the word of God.
Yes.
And of the testimony of Jesus Christ.
Now the prophets and the apostles.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Had the testimony of Jesus. I want the nation of Islam to listen at this good.
Yes, sir.
There was a prophet, I believe, named Malachi.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
Malachi taught us that Elijah will come.
In Malachi chapter 4.
Now, I want to find out who is this Elijah.
That's right.
Amen.
Is it the Imam?
Mm-hmm.
Is it the Mahdi?
Amen.
Is it Elijah Muhammad? Get the language of the Bible because it's not difficult for us.
No, no.
Amen. Thank God this thing that the revelation come unto us.
That's right.
Listen at the Bible.
Malachi chapter 4 and at verse 5.
What is it?
Behold.
Look.
I will send you Elijah.
I will send you Elijah.
The prophet.
The prophet.
Before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
Before the coming of the Lord, Elijah will come first.
And he shall turn the heart of the fathers.
He shall turn.
Amen.
The heart of the fathers.
To the children.
To the children.
And the heart of the children.
And the heart of the children to their fathers.
Lest I come.
Lest I come.
And smite the earth with a curse.
And smite the earth with the curse.
Amen.
Well, Elijah had to come.
Elijah.
But Elijah was already dead here.
That's right. Yes, he was.
Amen.
You had Elijah and you had Elisha.
That's right.
Elijah was a Tishbite.
That's right.
Elisha was a student or a son of the prophet Elijah.
That's right.
Elijah walked with God.
Amen.
Talked with God.
Amen.
And God was in him. But it came time that the chariots of fire or the power of God.
That's right.
Will come along and take the Tishbite.
Amen.
Elijah away.
Away. That's right.
And when Elisha saw the taking away and the translation.
Amen.
Of his teacher.
That's right.
Elijah. Before he went away.
That's right.
Elijah. Elisha wanted a double portion.
Double portion of the Spirit.
Of the Spirit.
That's right.
In other words, prophet of God.
Amen.
I want God to deal with me as he dealt with you.
That's right.
For he said, I want a double portion of your spirit.
Your spirit. And it came to pass.
Of
your spirit.
That's right.
The Bible says there is a spirit in man.
Amen.
And the inspiration of the Almighty giveth them the understanding.
That's right.
So Elisha want a double portion of the spirit of Elijah.
That's right.
In other words, the power you have with God.
Amen.
I want it.
That's right.
The way God talk with you.
Amen.
I want it.
That's right.
The way God walk with you.
That's right.
I want it.
Amen.
The way God deal with you. I want it.
That's right.
The way God just speak with you. When God come upon you, I want to come upon me.
That's right.
That when I smoke water,
that's right,
water will bow unto me.
That's right.
I want a double portion of the spirit.
That's right.
The way God handle you, I want him to handle me.
That's right. That's right.
Are you listening?
And Elisha said, I pray thee.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Follow me in your Bible.
In 2 Kings 2 and at verse
1. Oh, this is good tonight.
And Elijah said, I pray thee.
Elijah.
Amen.
Said, I pray thee.
Let a double portion.
Let a double portion.
Of thy spirit.
Of thine spirit.
Be upon me.
Be upon me.
And he said, thou hast asked a hard
thing. You ask a hard thing.
Nevertheless.
Nevertheless.
If thou see me when I am taken.
If you hang around me.
Amen. That's it. That's it.
Amen.
That's right. That's right.
If you hang around me.
If thou see me. Go ahead.
Don't just come and disappear.
That's right.
Stay there.
That's right. Amen.
As long as you stay there,
amen,
what I have will rub off on you, but you got to stay there.
That's right. That's right.
Don't get in a hurry.
Amen.
That's right.
Don't profess you got my spirit and you don't have it.
That's right.
Wait.
That's right.
So your claim is legitimate.
That's right.
Like you preachers profess
go
that God called and saved and preached the gospel,
amen,
to all of a profession.
That's right.
Because
that's
when
right
I examine you, I don't see the God of Elisha in
that's
you.
Right. Amen.
Are you listening?
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
What did he say?
And Elisha said.
Well, Elisha said.
I pray thee, let a double portion
thee,
of thy spirit.
Let a double portion.
Amen.
Of thine spirit.
Be upon me.
Let it get a hold of me.
And he said, thou hast asked a hard thing.
Do you know what you're asking?
That's it.
Amen. Hmm?
Amen.
All right.
Nevertheless, if thou see me.
Nevertheless, if you see me.
When I am taken from thee.
When I'm gone away from here.
It shall be so unto thee.
You'll have it.
But if not.
But if not.
It shall not be so.
You got to hang around.
That's it.
Huh?
That's right.
A lot of men want to preach, but they don't want to hang around a teacher.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
You got to hang around a teacher.
That's right.
Who's taught of God.
Amen.
God is the master teacher.
That's right.
Then God make a student. And bless him to master what he learned.
That's right.
And after he master what he learned,
amen,
he is able to impart mastery to others.
That's right.
Do you get what I'm talking?
That's right.
What did he say?
And it came to pass.
It came to pass as they still went on
and talked
and had a chat.
That behold, there appeared a chariot.
There appeared the power of God.
And horses of fire.
Horses of fire.
And parted them both.
And separated them.
And Elijah went up.
Elijah.
Amen.
Went up.
By a whirlwind into heaven. My Lord.
Elijah went up.
Elijah went up. Amen.
By a whirlwind into heaven.
And Elisha saw it.
And Elisha saw it.
And he cried, my father,
my father.
My father.
He wasn't his natural father.
No.
But he was his teacher.
That's right.
God took his teacher away.
That's right.
And when God took his teacher, the spirit that was in his teacher had to come on him to promote him from student to teacher.
That's right. That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
You bear in mind when God took Moses, long as Moses was here, Joshua was a student.
That's right.
But when God took Moses away, Joshua still was a student until God said,
that's right.
Now.
That's right.
Now,
that's
Joshua.
Right. Now, amen.
Come on up.
That's right.
Leave this people over. Well, a student couldn't do it.
No, no.
So now he had to be elevated from student now
right
to teacher.
That's right.
Wonderful.
That's right.
But he couldn't teach nothing different from his former teacher.
Amen.
If you called and sent by God, Mr. Apostle Amen. And preacher, your gospel don't have a right to detour from the prophets That's and right. the apostles.
That's right.
Because there's one master teacher.
That's right.
And anyone that's sent out by the master teacher Amen. Have the same message.
That's right.
Have the same faith.
That's right.
Recognize the same God.
Amen. That's right.
Amen.
Are you listening?
That's right.
What did he say?
My father, the chariot of Israel and the horsemen.
Chariot of Israel and the horsemen thereof.
And he saw him no more.
He didn't see him no more.
And he took hold of his own clothes and rent them
he
in two
took
pieces.
His own clothes and rent them in two pieces.
He took up also the mantle of Elijah.
He took up a garment.
That's right.
A mantle was part of his clothing.
That's right.
That's why you can't do anything in your clothing.
No, no.
Huh?
Amen.
When a woman touched the hem of the Lord's garment, virtue came out the man.
That's right.
Virtue didn't come out of the garment. It came out the man, but it was who was wearing the garment.
That's right.
Yes. Are you listening?
That's right.
Aaron's rod wasn't just a common branch.
Oh, no. No, no.
When the Bible talked about his rod did bud.
That's Amen.
Right. Oh, you understand?
Amen.
The budding of anything is the beginning of life.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Do you understand?
Amen.
When a seed, when a bud, when you look at a branch, and you see buds.
Amen.
It is the beginning of life.
Life. That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
And when his rod did bud, the beginning of the Spirit of God was beginning to work within Moses and Joshua.
That's right.
The rod also represents the Son of God.
That's right.
For the Son of God was called a stem.
That's right.
A stem is a rod.
Amen.
And John said about the man child that was born, he will rule all nations
with
a rod of iron.
That's right.
Isaiah said that a stem shall come forth out of Jesse.
Amen.
But before you got a stem, you got to have a seed.
That's right.
Before you have a stem, you got to have dirt.
That's right.
So here comes dirt, which was Mary, which was land.
That's right.
Dry ground. God being a husbandman,
Amen.
A husbandman is a farmer.
That's right.
So when God tilled the ground, he worked on the body of the woman.
Right.
Seed was planted there.
Amen.
Then when her body became fertilized, she was conceived by the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
And then when the body came out, here we come, the offspring of David,
That's
and
right.
out the tribe of Judah.
That's right.
Because David doors, which was the birth canal of the woman.
Amen.
Glory to God. Amen. Came open.
That's right. That's right.
And here come Amen. The Son of the Most High God.
That's right.
You know, sometime in logging, they have a canal.
Amen.
And they take logs and put them on the canal so the logs can travel.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
That's what God did.
That's right.
He come along and formed the body, and then the body traveled.
That's right.
Until it came at the time of the birthplace.
That's right.
And it came out of the birth canal, and the doors
That's right.
of the tribe of Judah came open,
Amen.
And a priest
That's right.
Go ahead.
That Moses never gave attention to at the altar.
That's right.
Amen. Arrived on the scene.
This that is glory.
That was the Messiah.
That's right.
That was the Mahdi.
That's right.
That was the Rabbi.
Amen.
Go ahead.
That was and is the Master Teacher.
This that is glorious.
Glory. I hope you can get this.
Amen.
The Bible says what?
This that is glorious in
this
his apparel.
That is glorious
in his apparel.
In his apparel. His appearance was magnificent.
That's right.
While he walked among us.
That's right.
He was different from any other man.
Amen.
He was not like no other man.
Oh, no.
So I said, oh, he was just like me, because the Bible said, as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, he also likewise himself took part of the same. Well, if he was just like you, then why couldn't you die for us?
That's right.
Tell us.
That's right.
Tell us.
If he was direct equal to everybody, Amen. Moses. Mm-hmm. Should have died for us.
That's right.
And the law would not have been faulty.
That's right.
In fact, any of the prophets would have been able to die.
That's right.
But you had to have the Messiah.
The Messiah. Amen.
The prophets.
Amen.
The prophet of all prophets.
That's right.
He was the high priest of our profession.
That's right.
In Arabic, he's called Demati.
Amen.
And Hebrew is called the Rabbi. Why you think Nicodemus said Rabbi?
Rabbi, that's right.
When he rose,
that's right.
The woman said Rabboni.
That's right.
In another language, Rabbi.
Rabbi.
What you mean? Teacher.
That's right.
Nicodemus said, I know that thou art a teacher.
Come from God.
You come from God.
That's right.
Because no man can do the things that you do
except
unless God be with him. Don't tell me he's just a prophet.
That's right. That's true. Amen.
Do you get what I'm talking?
That's right.
You're more than a prophet.
That's right.
But what else are you? I'm a healer.
A healer.
What else? I'm a resurrection, so don't look too far off.
That's right.
I'm life eternal.
That's right. That's right.
If you want light, he's light.
Amen. I am the way.
If you want darkness, he's darkness.
That's right.
For the prophets declared light and darkness are equal to him.
That's right.
That's right. That's right.
Who ever heard of a prophet walking on water?
Amen.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
Who ever heard of a prophet take a little handful of fish, a little few things of bread,
Amen.
And feed thousands?
Amen.
He got to be more than a prophet.
That's right.
Who would have heard of angels coming from heaven just to minister unto him?
That's right. That's right. Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Yes, he's more than a prophet,
That's
Islam.
Right. Amen.
You don't read angels in the Quran come minister to Muhammad.
No,
sir.
Master Farag Muhammad is not even mentioned in the Quran.
Amen. That's right.
God creating himself from the darkness. That statement is nowhere in the Quran.
Amen. Amen.
Good teaching.
That's right.
Are you listening to me?
That's right.
Go back to the book of Malachi. Let's finish up this Elijah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
We're going to see, was it Muhammad or someone else with the spirit of a man?
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Listen at the Bible.
Back in Malachi 4 and at verse 5.
Oh, yes. This is good.
Yes, it is.
This is taster's choice.
That's right.
Come on, son.
Behold, I will send you Elijah.
I will send you Elijah, the prophet.
Before the coming of the great
before and the Lord come.
Of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
And he shall turn the heart of the fathers to the children.
Yes.
And the heart of the children to their fathers.
Uh-huh.
Lest I come and smite the earth with a curse.
All right. Now, Amen. I'm going to send Elijah. Now, follow me in your Bible.
In Luke chapter 1.
Yes.
And begin reading at verse 15.
All right.
For he shall be great in the sight of the Lord.
You better go to verse 14.
At verse 14. And thou shalt have joy and gladness.
Thou shalt have joy and gladness.
And many shall rejoice at his birth.
Many shall rejoice at his birth. It's talking about someone else coming into the world.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
All right.
For he shall be great in the sight of the Lord.
He shall be great in God's eyes.
And shall drink neither wine nor
And shall
drink.
Not drink wine or strong drink, showing you that the birth of this child, he's going to be a Nazarite from birth.
That's right.
Separated unto God.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
And he shall be filled with the Holy
he
Ghost.
He shall be filled
with the Holy
with
Ghost.
The Holy Ghost, which is equal to the double portion of the spirit of Elijah.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
And he shall be filled with the Holy
he
Ghost.
He shall be filled with God.
Even from his mother's womb.
Even from the womb.
And many of the children of Israel.
Many.
Amen.
Of the children of Israel.
Shall he turn to the Lord their God.
Shall he turn to the Lord their God.
And he shall go before him.
He shall go before him.
In the spirit.
In the spirit.
And power.
And the power.
Of Elias.
Of Elias.
To turn the hearts of the fathers
He's
to
going,
their children.
Right. And what did the prophet Malachi say Elijah going
to
do?
And he shall turn the heart of the fathers to the children.
And when John the Baptist get here with the spirit of Elijah upon him, what he going
to
do?
To turn the hearts of the fathers to the children.
What else?
And the disobedient to the wisdom of the just.
What else?
To make ready a people prepared for the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
John the Baptist.
And in Luke 1 and at verse 13.
Was that Elijah?
But the angel said unto him, Fear not, Zechariah.
Fear not, Zechariah.
For thy prayer is heard.
Thine prayer is heard.
And thy wife Elizabeth
Your wife Elizabeth shall bear a son.
And thou shalt call his name.
Thou shalt call his name.
John.
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 John was that prophet.
That's right.
That's right. That's right. Amen.
Why did he have a double portion?
Amen.
Of the Spirit.
Of the Spirit.
Jesus said of them born of a woman. Mm-hmm. It's not a greater prophet than John.
That's right.
What made John great?
Amen.
John would baptize the greatest ambassador in the world.
That's right. That's right.
Jesus was not only God, mm-hmm. but he was the representative of God.
That's right. That's right. Yes, he was.
Jesus.
That's right.
Was not only God.
Amen.
That's right.
But he was the express image of God.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
In other words, he was the total reflection.
Amen.
Right.
He represents the perfection,
That's
the
right.
perfectness of God.
That's right. That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Nobody represents God like Jesus
like
did.
Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Because all men count slackness.
That's right.
Amen.
But Jesus represents God so well.
Amen.
He was perfect in all things.
That's right.
Amen.
Never erred.
No, no.
Amen.
Never made mistakes.
That's right.
Tempted at all points and yet didn't blunder.
And he that sent me.
Listen at the Bible.
In John 8 and verse 29.
He that sent me.
Is with me.
Yes, sir.
For the Father hath not left me alone.
Well, let me make it more hot for you.
Amen.
In other words, he that sent me.
Is with me.
Listen. He that sent me.
Amen.
Is me.
Is me.
That's right.
That's right. Go ahead.
That's Get right. this radio listeners.
Amen.
He that sent me.
That's right.
Is me.
St. John chapter 12.
Listen.
And at verse 44.
I'm going to build with Bible.
Jesus cried and said.
Jesus cried and said.
He that believeth on me.
He that believeth on me.
Believeth not on me.
Not on me.
But on him.
But on him.
That sent me.
That sent me.
And he that seeth me.
He that see me.
Seeth him.
You see him.
That sent me.
That sent me.
That's right. That's right. Amen. Amen.
He was the total reflection of God.
That's right. Yes, he was. Amen.
When you see Jesus.
Amen.
He was so close connected to God. He thought it not robbery.
Equal with God.
To be equal with him.
That's right.
Amen.
And yet the Lord already said in the prophets,
Who is my equal?
Saith the Holy One.
That's right.
But Jesus thought it not robbery.
Amen. To be
In other words, I'm not taking nothing.
That's right.
From nobody.
That's right.
I'm not stealing nothing when I talk like God.
That's right. That's right.
I'm not stealing nothing when I walk like God.
Amen. That's right.
I'm not stealing nothing when I turn waters into wine.
That's right. Go ahead.
I'm not stealing nothing when thunder talk and only I understand the grammar thereof.
That's right. God is not robbed.
I'm not stealing nothing when I say if I call 10,000 legion of angels.
That's right.
I'm not stealing nothing.
God is not robbery.
I'm not stealing nothing by when the scripture says he was in the world and the world was made
by him.
Right. By him.
That's right.
And yet the world didn't know him.
That's right.
I'm not stealing nothing when I say, Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani.
That's right.
My God, why hast thou forsaken me?
Amen.
I'm not stealing nothing when I say, destroy this temple. But in 3 days, I'll be back.
That's right.
Courage to God.
Robbery.
Huh?
Amen.
He thought it not robbery.
To be equal.
And if you're equal to God, you must be God.
That's right. That's right. Must be.
Now let me ask a question.
Go ahead.
What man can be God?
That's right.
That's right. All right.
Oh, this is deep stuff.
Yes, it is.
Amen.
If the you're equal to God, you got to be God, but it's not a man living that ever was God.
That's right. God is not a man.
Amen. Break it down.
That's true. That's right.
Do you hear the prophet in the book of Numbers?
Numbers 23 and verse 19.
What?
God is not a man.
God is not a man.
That he should lie.
That he should lie.
Neither the Son of Man.
Neither the Son of Man.
That he should repent.
Jesus.
Amen.
Was a man.
Was a man.
Jesus was God.
That's right.
But what part was God? 2 Corinthians.
Amen.
Chapter 5.
Chapter 5. Amen.
Will show you what part.
Amen.
Of the Messiah. Was God.
That's right.
And that's why he thought it not robbery to be equal with God.
That's right.
Listen.
2 Corinthians 5 and at verse 18.
What is it?
And all things are of God.
All things are of God.
Who hath reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And hath given to us the ministry of reconciliation.
The ministry of reconciliation.
To wit.
Listen. Listeners.
Amen.
To wit.
That God.
That God. Hold it.
Go ahead.
To wit that God.
That God. Go ahead.
A particular God.
That God. That's right.
The God.
Go ahead.
Amen.
That God.
Amen.
That Jehovah. Amen. That I am.
That's right.
That God. Why that God? Because they're God's many.
God's many. That's right.
That's right.
Go ahead. Amen.
To wit.
That God.
That God.
That's right. That's
what?
Right. Was in Christ.
Was in Christ.
Reconciling the world.
Pulling the world.
Unto himself.
What you mean? Water separate Jersey from Philadelphia.
That's right.
So a bridge must be built. Amen. To connect. That's the right. Two states.
That's
or
right.
The two cities.
Amen.
Jesus. Mm-hmm. Was the manifestation of God.
That's right.
The flesh, the man.
Amen.
The shape. The body, the son, the prophet, the lamb, the minister.
That's right.
Was not God.
Oh, no. That's right.
So God was not born.
That's right. That's right.
He's too large for Mary to birth him.
That's right. Amen.
But Job said he's higher than heaven.
Amen.
Deeper than hell.
That's right.
Broader than the sea and longer than the earth.
Amen.
The man was had the title God.
That's right.
But God the Spirit was the force in the man.
In the man. That's right.
So when we say Jesus Christ is God, we're not talking about what Mary birthed.
No, no.
We're talking about the part that overshadowed Mary.
That's right.
And created the holy thing in Mary.
That's right.
And then when the thing was made by God, it inherited the same name that God had.
That's right.
Jesus.
That's right.
For the name Jesus is an inherited name.
In Hebrews 1 and at verse 4.
For when you got a will, you leave something for someone else.
That's right.
That they may inherit it.
Amen.
The Bible says, lo!
Amen.
I come.
I come.
It is written
of me.
Of me to do thine will.
That's right.
Oh God.
God. Amen.
So God had a will.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
That's right.
And he searched around heaven.
That's right.
To see who can do his will.
That's right.
Revelation chapter 5.
And at verse 3.
Move fast.
And no man in heaven.
No man in heaven.
Nor in earth.
Nor in earth.
Neither under the earth.
I went down underneath the earth.
Was able to open the book.
But nobody was able to open the book.
Neither to look thereon.
And neither to look thereon.
And I wept much.
And I cried.
Because no man
because
was found
no
worthy.
Man was found worthy.
To open and to read the book.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Neither to look thereon.
To open, to read the book, and to look thereon.
And one of the elders.
They're one of the elders. One of the elders.
That's right.
You see, around the throne, you got 24 seats.
Amen.
Those seats set 24 elders.
That's right.
Where do you get 24 from? Mm-hmm. You had 12 tribes of Israel.
Amen.
He came and chose 12 apostles.
That's right.
So one of the elders talked to him.
Amen.
And when just one of the elders talked to him, that was representing the prophets.
Go ahead.
And the apostles.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Because Jesus come to fulfill the law.
That's right.
And when you come to fulfill the law, you can't do it without fulfilling the prophecies.
That's right.
Because the prophecies talked about him.
That's right.
Are you listening?
That's right.
What did he say?
And one of the elders saith unto me,
what?
Weep not.
Weep not.
Behold.
Behold.
The Lion of the tribe of Judah.
There's a lion.
Amen.
Out of a tribe.
Out of a tribe.
There's power.
That's right.
Coming out of a tribe.
That's right.
Of Judah.
Of Judah.
What?
The root of David.
There's a root.
Amen.
Amen.
If you're a plant, you got to have roots.
That's right. That's right.
Isaiah said that he shall grow up before him as a tender plant.
And as a root.
And as a root.
Out of a dry ground.
Mary's body was the dry ground, and as she began to grow, roots began to get deeper.
That's right.
Amen. Are you listening?
That's right.
Come on, son.
Weep not, behold the Lion of the tribe of Judah.
The root?
The root of David hath prevailed.
Hath prevailed.
To open the book.
To open the book means to fulfill the book.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Give me the 29th chapter of the book of Isaiah.
Isaiah.
Move fast.
Amen.
My time is getting away and my head just getting flooded with scripture.
Amen.
Glory to God. Amen. I don't need the choir to sing me out. Amen. Amen. Get the language of the Bible. It says to open
Amen.
The book.
To open the book.
Now, the Bible is no good to us closed.
That's right.
But when you open the Bible and yet don't understand it, it's still closed while it's open.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Amen. So to open the book just don't mean to Preach open it. Up something and Teach flip it. The leaves of it.
That's right.
No, to open means Teach to understand.
That's right.
So when a door is open, then you can enter in.
Go ahead.
So when the book is open Amen. And Jesus said, no man comes to the Father except by me, the opening of the book represents the manifestation of God.
That's right.
And when God manifests himself, he opened up the way.
That's right.
He said, for I am the way.
That's right.
How is the way come? It come through words.
That's right.
It come through knowledge.
That's right.
It come through demonstration.
Amen.
It come in parables.
That's right.
It come in examples. For me to understand God's way, I got to hear it.
That's right.
For me to hear it, there got to be a teacher.
That's right. Go ahead.
Who can teach us God's way better than God?
Better than God. That's right.
That's why preachers. It takes God to make a preacher.
Amen.
It ain't a man living Amen. Can show you God's way better than God.
That's right.
So God
Go ahead.
Gotta get in the man.
Amen.
Just like
That's right.
He got in the Son of God.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
And as the angels ministered unto him,
Amen.
Amen.
Oh yeah.
God will in turn minister unto his servant.
That's right.
That's right.
Are you listening?
Amen.
Minister means to serve.
Amen.
God serve him by teaching him.
That's right.
God serve his tongue.
Go ahead.
God serve his tongue
right.
through live coal.
That's right.
Taken from the altar.
That's right.
By the tongues.
That's right.
You just can't handle the coal or the power of God within your own instrument.
No.
You need something that's ordained of God.
That's right.
The tongues, when you get the tongues, that is an instrument
made
to handle hot cold.
Go ahead. That's right.
When you got the wisdom of God, that's the instrument.
That's right.
Made.
That's right.
To handle.
Go ahead.
Understanding.
That's right.
Wonderful.
Are you listening?
That's right.
Come on, son.
Isaiah 29 and at verse 10.
What is it?
For the Lord hath poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep.
The spirit of deep sleep.
And hath closed your eyes.
Close your eyes.
The prophets,
the prophets and your rulers.
The seers hath he covered.
Covered.
And the vision of all.
The vision of all.
Is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed.
See. You see that?
That's right.
The Bibles are on the pulpits throughout America and the world.
Amen.
Got them in Congress.
That's right.
Got them in the courthouses.
That's right.
Got them in the Masonic Lodge.
Amen.
Got them in the synagogue.
That's right.
Got them in the mosque.
That's right.
Got them in the whorehouses.
Amen.
Got them on the dashboards of your car.
That's right. That's
got them between the two lesbians.
That's true.
Got them between the gay man.
That's right.
When a gay man married a gay priest got a Bible.
That's right.
When a lesbian woman married a lesbian woman, another lesbian got a Bible.
That's right.
But the word is closed.
The vision of
the
all.
The vision.
Vision.
Amen.
That means the ability to understand.
That's right.
What is written in the book.
It has become unto you.
It has become unto you.
As the words
equal to words of a book
that is sealed.
The prophets had a vision.
That's true. Go ahead.
What you mean they had a vision? They saw something.
That's right.
And they told us about it.
That's right.
But without the Spirit of God, when you go into the book,
amen,
it is as a night vision.
As a night vision.
But you don't see nothing.
That's right.
You're dark. Your understanding is darkened, and you're alienated from the life of God because of the ignorance that is in you, because of the blindness that is in your heart.
Amen.
Go back to Revelation.
Amen. Wonderful.
Amen. There's so much ground to cover.
Still in Revelation 5.
But you
5.
Bear with me a little while in my folly.
And at verse 5.
Huh?
And one of the elders saith unto me.
One of the elders talked to me.
Weep not.
Don't cry.
Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah.
The Lion out of Judah's tribe.
The root of David.
David's root.
Hath prevailed to
David's offspring.
The book.
Meaning Jesus sprung from David and David sprung from him.
That's right.
Amen. David sprung from God first.
That's right.
Because God created him.
Amen.
The Bible says, have we not all one Father, have not one God created
yes.
us?
Amen.
Then that same God come on and created the house with David and sprung from him.
That's right.
That's why he's called the root and the offspring of David. All right.
The root of David hath prevailed to open the book.
And what?
And to loose the seven seals thereof.
Now, seven seals.
Seven seals.
Seven seals.
Amen.
When a thing is sealed, it is approved.
That's right.
Are you listening?
That's right.
But someone must be authorized to put the seal.
That's right.
And give the approval.
Give the approval.
Only the Spirit of the living God can put its approval.
That's right.
Upon a man.
That's right.
Upon a preacher.
Amen.
That the seal or the words of the scriptures may get loose.
That's right.
Huh?
That's true. Amen.
Do you see?
Go ahead.
Amen.
All
right, sir. Sometimes it takes to get a building loose, you need some explosives sometimes.
That's right. Amen.
In other words, you need something greater than the building itself.
That's right.
To get it loose.
Amen.
In order for the words in the Bible to shift.
Amen.
To get some activity from the letter.
That's right.
Now understand this. The letter killeth.
The letter killeth.
The letter killeth.
That's right.
But yet the Bible is letter.
Yes it is.
But the letter killeth.
That's right.
The letter without the Spirit is unprofitable.
That's right.
That's what is meant. The letter killeth, but the Spirit make alive. You can read the Bible without understand. You're like the letter that don't have power. Dead.
Who also hath made us
lifeless.
That's right. That's right.
But with the Spirit of God, it resurrects the letter.
That's right.
Because the Spirit that approve and move men to write the letter must now get in you.
Get in you. That's right.
To interpret the letter.
That's right.
Then the words have movement.
That's right.
Understand thee come.
Amen.
Listen at the Bible.
Hath prevailed to open the book.
Yes.
And to loose the seven seals thereof.
Uh-huh.
In 2 Corinthians 3 and at verse 6.
All right.
Who also hath made us able ministers.
Are you listening?
Of the New Testament. Amen.
You Jews say the New Testament is no good.
Amen.
You hang to the Torah. And the Bible talked about you.
That's right.
That's right.
But they talk about the blindness.
Blindness. That's right.
That is until this day.
That's right.
Of the reading of the Old Testament.
The Old Testament. Amen.
Because there are things in the Old Testament about today.
But their minds.
Listen.
In 2 Corinthians 3 and at verse 14.
All right.
But their minds were blind.
Their minds were blinded.
For until this day.
Until now.
Remaineth the same veil.
The same veil.
Untaken away.
Untaken away.
In the reading of the Old Testament.
Let me show you a veil that haven't moved. Under us. Child is born.
That's right.
Son is given.
That's right.
Government shall be upon his shoulder.
Amen.
And his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
That's right.
Daniel talk about the Messiah is coming.
Amen.
But yet the Jews of that Old Testament prophecy, that veil is still upon them.
That's right.
It is untaken away. Those scales is still on their eyes.
That's right. For until this day.
Listen at the book.
For until this day.
Until this day.
Remaineth the same veil.
Same one. Not a new one.
Not a new one.
Thousands of years have passed over.
Amen.
And now the children of the fathers got the same veil.
Same veil.
Yeah.
Remaineth the same veil.
Remain the same veil.
Untaken away.
Untaken away.
In the reading of the Old Testament.
In the reading of the Old Testament.
Which veil is done away in Christ. Amen.
The veil is done away
in Christ.
In Christ.
But even unto this
that's
day.
That's what the scales on the eyes of Paul symbolize.
That's right.
Because he was a Jew.
That's right.
A Benjamite. All he knew was the law.
That's right.
But he noticed the Bible said it fell from his eyes as it were.
Scales.
Scales.
Scales. That's right.
His eyes came open. Oh, he knew about Jehovah. He believed in him.
That's right.
But yeah, he was ignorant of him.
That's right.
Is my time gone? Listen to what the Bible said.
Still in 2 Corinthians 3 and at verse 14.
Uh-huh.
But their minds were blinded.
Yes.
For until this day remaineth the same veil,
uh-huh,
untaken away in the reading of the Old Testament.
Yes.
Which veil is done away in Christ. But even unto this day, when Moses is read, the veil is upon their heart.
Now, you remember when Jesus was on the cross? The Bible says the temple, the veil of the temple was rent in twain. That means rent in two.
That's right. Yeah.
Mm.
Amen. That's right.
Hmm?
That's right.
Yeah. Amen.
The veil of the temple rent in two.
Yes.
Why did it rent in two?
Because
mm-hmm, there was two temples there.
That's right.
Amen.
One veil represent the law. And when it, see, when it, see, it tore.
That's right.
And when it tore, mm-hmm, one part of that veil mm-hmm represent the law.
Amen.
And the other part of that veil represent grace.
That's right.
So the tearing of the veil splitting.
Mm-hmm.
It also broke down the enmity.
Amen.
And the wall and the dam.
That's right.
That was built.
That's right.
That separated Jew and Gentile.
In Ephesians 2.
So you had two veils that broke.
That's right.
The veil of the natural temple that was built. And a veil that was hanging on the tree.
On the tree.
Amen.
Listen at the Bible.
In Ephesians chapter 2 and at verse 13.
I hope you get this. If you can't follow me, get the tape because I know you're missing a lot.
That's right.
Get the tape. Go to school, learn, and know who is your God.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
What did he say?
In Ephesians 2 and verse 13.
What is it?
But now in Christ Jesus.
Yes.
Ye who sometimes were far off
uh-huh
are made nigh by the blood of Christ.
Yes.
For he is our peace.
He is our peace.
Who hath made both one.
Yes.
And hath broken down the middle wall of partition between us.
The Bible says he consecrated.
Amen.
A new mm-hmm and living way through
the veil.
The veil.
That is to say,
give chapter and verse in the book of Hebrew.
In Hebrews 10 and at verse 20.
Listen.
By a new and living way.
By a new and living way.
Which he hath consecrated for
which
us.
Which he hath consecrated, ordained.
For us.
For us.
Through the veil.
Through the veil.
That is to say.
His what?
His flesh.
Amen. Wonderful.
When the veil of the temple was torn. That represent the wall being broken down between Jew and Gentile. His veil was torn.
Amen.
Because some tissue was torn.
Yes, sir.
Pierced his hands and feet.
That's
true. Pierced him in the side.
Amen.
There was a torn veil there.
Amen.
That is to say, his flesh. Are you listening?
Amen.
I'm going to quit.
Yes.
Holy Ghost covered quite a bit of ground.
Yes.
Once we are baptized and have the Holy Ghost, we just can't say Jesus Christ is God. We got to get into the soup.
Yes.
Hmm? I want to say, well, I believe Jesus Christ is God. Why? Well, Bishop Johnson says so. That ain't good enough. You got to get into the soup. You got to dig it up. Stir it up. Taste it. Roll around in your mouth. Hmm? Taste the Lord and see that he's good. But before you taste him, get the language of the Bible. If it says taste the Lord and see that he's good before you can taste him, somebody got to know how to serve you. So you open your mouth wide and let God fill it. Everybody all right? There's a lot of information God gave. And I'm glad God bless us with broad wisdom because we have all type of religions listening. I swear that ship Jesus come from was an old story about slaves waiting on a ship named Jesus. And that's where Islam say a ship is coming from heaven to get the children of Allah or the children of God. And the ship gone. Take us away. Only ship I get on to be on a big boat. If I get on that. Take knowledge. Value it.
When you get the tapes, use it as a study guide. When you hear someone tell you, oh, I don't need it as a study guide, don't pay them no mind. They'll let you know they're a fool.
That's right.
If God ain't teaching you, you need somebody to teach you.
That's right. That's right.
Use it as a study guide. Follow it in your Bible.
That's
right. Don't look at videotapes for entertainment.
That's right.
Learn. Because what you're watching and what you're hearing is going to stare you back in your face in eternity.
That's right.
May God forever keep you all and preserve you.
Amen.